bowls. If you haven't heard these before, these are relaxing. They're intended to help you get in a nice deep, almost a sleep state if you choose this time of the evening. And just kick back and relax and let the tones wash through and around you. As much as being music, these are healing tools. And we like to use them for deep relaxation and inner work, deep inner work, getting in touch with your real self, so to speak, and basically just letting yourself kick back and enjoy them. And that's how I play them. I just kick back and play them. Anything we need to deal with this earlier? How's our sound working out there in the world? Okay, if you're having any issues, please let us know through the chat window. Debbie will be happy to talk with you. As you may know, we're trying a new system tonight to try to improve the broadcast quality. And it's always fun to try something new and see how it works. So I'll just play the bowls and we'll see how it comes through for you. Thanks for watching. If you've been watching our show, you probably already know that these bowls are tuned to the different notes of the musical scale. So part of what happens when you listen to them is you sort of receive a sound bath throughout the body. Different parts of the body are said to resonate with different tones and therefore different bowls. So when you're listening to this whole set, which covers all the range of the musical scale, you're able to receive an energy tune-up sort of thing, kind of a rejuvenation of the body and the cells in the body, just by letting the sounds resonate wherever they may. Different tones are said to resonate in different parts of the body, but as important, or maybe more important than that, is that you receive an overall sound bath by having the entire musical scale playing through you, sort of using your body as a tuning fork and tuning it up as it goes. So I play usually a combination of different sounds, and that brings about the movement of energy through the body in different ways. Thank you. liquid gold fused into the process when it's made along with the crystal. So its tone is kind of a merging of crystal and the Tibetan bowls. You may hear a slight metallic sound to it, a very strong sound. Also has a bit of a metallic sheen to it. Birds outside at sundown tweeting along with the crystal bowls. They're tweeting their song and I'm playing with them, I guess. Don't know if that's coming through on the mic, but it's nice.
Thank you.
are you doing so far? Are you relaxing out there? I like these nighttime sessions because you can really get into that relaxed space. Seems to do it for me when I play them too. Usually helps you sleep better at night after you've listened to bowls like this. You hear that one still buzzing? This is a G chakra, G note, throat chakra. Notice with the red one and the green one how easy it is to play them. These are new ones for us. You just barely touch them to get that sound out of them. Kind of like a wet finger in a wine glass, except stronger. This is a F note for the heart chakra. You may be feeling it in that part of the body. This is a C sharp, said to resonate in the adrenal glands. I'm sitting right between them, so I should be getting the vibrations from both. Hopefully they're coming across to you too. How's that new encoder working for everybody, Debbie? Any comments?
Fine.
Sounds good for us anyway, coming through. We're hoping. Thank you. we doing out there in the world? Anything to address, Debbie?
Well, chat's pretty quiet, but I think we're all in La La Land.
Well, that's the best place to go with these bowls, I think. Mm-hmm. Let's go La La Land.
Yeah. Say hi to Lee and Steven, or I guess I just did.
Hi, Lee. Hi, Steven. And now I did. I hope this is all coming through good for you this time. Sounds like it must be. Good. Good. There must be somebody I haven't played here tonight. My bowls get jealous if they don't get played evenly, so. Aqua Gold's doing well tonight. What shall we do now, then? Yeah. Okay. Ultralight bowl. It's very light, very thin, and plays really nicely. Said to time of the evening for you to get ready to fall asleep at some point, and or if you have difficulties falling asleep, just imagine yourself taking these vibrations into your body, letting your body know it's okay to relax, let go of whatever tension or stress it may be holding on to. Just let these vibrations take you into a dream state. Sometimes I use my own discs that I've made to fall asleep to at night. It's pretty peaceful. rest out there? I keep playing. Encore, encore. I think I'm a little over my first time slot, but I'm willing to play through more. It's fun. Still early here. I suppose if you're in Iceland or somewhere, it's not early. Europe. And it's definitely bedtime. Free bird or something on Crystal Bowls. It's one of our favorite songs. I don't think I can play them this on bowls. Anything to address, Debbie?
Nope.
No questions, no answers, no anything, huh?
Nope, you're just
lulling us all. That tends to happen. I usually have a pretty quiet audience in person, too. I think it's the biggest challenge they face is not snoring too loudly, but disturbing the other people. I love it because it just tells me they're going in deep. I was just thinking we have a live audience for one of these shows, but probably nobody would know it because everybody'd be zoned out here. Grounding sound. best sounding salad bowl, except it's pure crystal. You may have seen these before, Buddhist tinctures from, these are from made in Nepal. They have the eight auspicious symbols of Buddhism on them. They weigh 4 pounds. Resonate nicely. Is everybody still asleep? Debbie looks like she's asleep back there. I don't know. Maybe anybody's been trying to chat with her. Thank you. Anybody still with me? You're all asleep now, a bit, I hope. It's been almost an hour, so an hour of crystal singing bowls is about as much as anybody can endure without falling asleep, I think. Hopefully. This is one musical instrument where you want the people to fall asleep. Still alert and conscious, check out the rewards that I've done for exclusives for Concert Window. I think there's some pretty cool things there that I can do in the mixing room that I can't quite do live that I think you'll enjoy. And we will be doing another one of these this weekend, I believe. We haven't set the date yet, but we'll continue to do two or three a week. Possibility we'll do a daytime one on Sunday as well as another nighttime one soon. So we look forward to having you watch again, and again, give us feedback if you have any about how it came through for you and all. We always like to hear how it's all working. Anything else, Debbie? Anything I need to do? Cool. She says no. So I'll just sign off with you this time, and we'll hope to have you watching again soon. Good night.